Welcome to another episode of Soul Aligned Success. Today I'm going to help you identify the difference between your passions and your purpose. Hi there, and I just wanted to talk about this topic because I see it frustrating so many spiritual entrepreneurs when they come and they tell me that they're multi-passionate and how can they just choose one thing? And I just wanted to state that there's a difference between your passions and your purpose. You are allowed to be multi-passionate. I mean, think about it. Like, how boring would the world be if you didn't have multiple passions, right? So for example, I'm very passionate about wellness travel, clean beauty, holistic fitness, nature travel, eating clean, living a laptop lifestyle. Like, I have all of these different passions, and technically any single one of these in and of themselves could be a business, right? Technically, I could go start a business around green beauty if that's what I wanted to do. And I'm not saying that this is wrong or right to do that, you know, as long as it's coming from inner alignment. So this message is specifically for a spiritual entrepreneur looking to build a soul aligned business, a purpose driven business, and is really feeling called to offer something of deep meaning to the world. There's a difference between your passion and your purpose, and part of the reason that you're frustrated why you're not able to pick just one passion is because I don't necessarily think you're supposed to pick one passion. I don't think you're really supposed to pick one passion at all. You're allowed to be multi-passionate, and your actual passions are not in and of themselves necessarily going to be your purpose-driven business model. So your passions are not your purpose, but when you follow your passions, they will lead you to your purpose. They will align you to your purpose. When you follow your passions and you follow your joy and you follow the spiritual breadcrumb of what lights you up, they will lead you to discovering your purpose, and they will likely support your purpose-driven work. So there are elements of all of my passions inside my program, Sacred Leader Academy. I very much teach entrepreneurs now how to live a laptop lifestyle and to make money online so they can really make a big impact worldwide, globally, through the media, more so than they could just do in their own community. And I teach them how to scale so that they have leverage, so they have that freedom lifestyle, so they can, you know, travel and do these things. And I very much support a holistic lifestyle as part of this, you know, foundation for, you know, being your most empowered version of yourself, right? So there's elements of my passions that are very much a part of my process and part of my purpose-driven business, right? And they support my lifestyle. And these pieces now also support my purpose-driven business model, but they are not in and of themselves my purpose, you know. So for example, my purpose is a layer deeper. It goes a layer deeper than just what the personality self enjoys as a preference. So you may like certain things, you may have passions about certain things, and yes, this is part of your soul speaking to you when you're, you know, in a light, following your passions and living a life of joy and following your joy, right? Because part of your journey is to enjoy your life, to have these multiple passions and to experience life through feeling alive and following your passions and following your joy. Like, this is part of your own human experience. So of course, multi-passionate is a given, right? Like, of course you're going to be multi-passionate. I see it stump a lot of spiritual entrepreneurs when they're trying to make one of their passions their purpose. And here's why they're trying to do this. If this is you, you're likely trying to make one of your passions your business model because you so want to be in alignment with your purpose. You're feeling the call to do something bigger than what you're doing now, possibly. Maybe you're feeling the call to get out of your 9-to-5 or your corporate job, or you're feeling the call to really break free and have that freedom lifestyle to be able to travel and make money online and do those kind of things and be a spiritual entrepreneur, which is what you're feeling called to do, right? And so it's almost from this needy energy that you're trying to make one of your passions your purpose. And it doesn't work that way. Your purpose is revealed to you. Your purpose is going to be a layer deeper than just what you're passionate about. Your purpose is going to be more closely tied to the transformation that you've overcome in your own life, and to it's going to be more revealed to you as you follow what it is that you're passionate about, right? And so your passions will lead you to your purpose, but they are not your purpose. And they can get misconstrued there, because sometimes people are really desperate to figure out what their purpose is. And right there, you can't figure out what your purpose is. It will be revealed to you, and you will come into alignment with it. And your passions, you may find, support you in your mission work or support you in your purpose work. And they definitely will support you living a life that feels in alignment and fulfilled and joyful. And so right there in and of themselves, they are serving your purpose, because you have your own inner purpose too, which is to live a life of freedom and to live a life of joy and to live a life of fun. So your passions, you don't have to choose between any single one of those. You get to choose them all. But if you make the mistake of trying to pigeonhole yourself and select one of your passions to become your purpose work, you might make the mistake that I made, which was I very much branded myself as, like, let's say, for example, when I first started, as a holistic lifestyle coach, because that was one of my passions. And it wasn't necessarily wrong per se to brand myself into that niche and, as a holistic lifestyle coach, I landed clients, I got results, I built my confidence, you know, and all of those things. It's always a learning experience, right? But something was falling flat and something was missing. And that's because I was trying to take one of my passions, because there's like this, I don't know who's out there saying this, that you have to pick one of your passions and turn it into your business, but that's not true. And I was doing that, and I took holistic fitness, because that's what I happen to be passionate about at the moment, still am, and turn that into a business, when really it was just an element of what I'm here to do. It was a piece of what I'm here to do. There was a much deeper layer to my purpose that I was just skimming the surface on, and my passions were leading me to it, but they were not my purpose. And it was my ego trying to force my purpose that forced me to rebrand several times. And so this was just something that I wanted to share with you. If you're sort of feeling frustrated, like you're banging your head against the wall trying to figure out what your purpose is, and you're trying to base it off of like what you're passionate about. Your passions are your passions. You're allowed to be multi-passionate. That's part of being human and enjoying this life experience. They're not necessarily going to be your purpose, but they can be intertwined, and they can lead you to your purpose if you allow it and release control and just follow your passions and allow yourself to dig a little deeper, ask some deeper self-reflective questions, and allow yourself to receive your purpose. Your purpose will come to you. And you'll see, looking back, once you stumble onto your purpose magically, you're going to see looking back that every single thing that you had been through, that you were passionate about, and or that you've learned through or grown through, is all going to culminate into this perfect synergy, which is becoming your purpose, right? Which reveals itself to you as more of a purpose-driven business and a purpose-driven mission. So resist the urge to scratch the surface as far as your passions go and what your personality enjoys and things like that, and twist that and put that into a box and call it your purpose-driven work or your purpose-driven business, and allow your purpose to unfold. Ask some more self-reflective questions on what's the deeper meaning behind my joy for this or that. Like, what is it that really lights me up about, you know, holistic, for my example, for holistic fitness or clean beauty or living a laptop lifestyle or traveling on a whim and all the things. Like, what's the underlying deeper element here that's connecting these passions? What is it that, you know, sort of ties it all together? And don't try to figure out the answer. Ask for the answer to be revealed to you. Ask Spirit to show you your next step. This is how you call in your purpose. And instead of trying to manipulate one of your passions into your purpose-driven work, and then doing what I did, which start to build a whole business around it and recognize that, oh, this was just a little piece of the pie that I was trying to force into something bigger than what it was. This is really just more for my own enjoyment and maybe elements of it moving forward, but I was trying to manipulate and twist it. And that's a fear-based thing to do. And it's also, it's because I was feeling a call on a deeper level, trying to figure it out, but trying to figure it out from a conceptual level, from a thinking level. And this is the level of the mind. This is the level of duality. Does this make sense? Does this passion make sense? Will I make money at this passion? Will people buy this? Will people buy that? You know, trying to figure it out conceptually instead of receiving what it was that I was really being guided to do. And so there's a huge difference there, because you can build a business around any one of your ideas. Any single one of them can be a thriving business. But there's a difference between a soul-aligned business and a business that just makes money, or, you know, there's a difference between soul-aligned success and being able to effortlessly align with the things that are meant for you versus trying to force it and figure it out, which obviously you see people doing that and they still make money, right? Or they still, you know, have certain luxuries, right? But that's not the same as having the full package, right? A full soul aligned success where you do something that lights you up from the inside out, that no longer feels like work, that is completely in alignment with your soul, where you don't even need to take vacations and travel for your life anymore, because your life just already feels like such a blessing that you don't need to plan the trips and the traveling and everything to get away from it, because it's just you morph into an expression of your purpose and everything becomes joyful and purposeful and has deeper meaning and brings you joy on a daily, regular, moment-to-moment basis. So I just wanted to leave you with this. I hope it resonates. I hope it's making sense to somebody. If you have any questions or comments, please drop them below this video wherever you're watching.